to your week three prenatal. So today you are going to need a ball, just a smallish ball, about maybe a football or something like that. If you haven't got one, we can try and do it without it, so don't worry too much. And you're going to need your tennis ball or massage ball. So you're going to start off gently popping some weight through the foot and rolling it on your ball. So you can do this seated if you want, but you're just trying to loosen off the tissues underneath the foot. You're not putting much weight on. You're doing all your toes, down the sides, round the heel, and through. If there's any sticky areas that you think, oh, that feels quite nice, just stick with them before you move on. And then take it to the other side. So I hope you're all well. You've got permission from your midwife. You've had something to eat. You've got a drink available. And then at any point during the session, you can pause it, have a drink, have a break, and come back to it when you're ready. And don't force any movements or hold your breath. Just want to be as natural as possible. So when you've finished off with your ball, don't want it to end. It's chosen to end itself. Get it out of the way, we don't need it anymore. So we're just going to start off lining ourselves up. So feet hip width apart, toes are facing forwards, and you're just going to rock gently through your feet, lifting your heels up slightly, and then the balls of your feet and your toes. Push some weight into your toes as you lift your heels up. Imagine you've got four corners in each foot, two at the front, two at the back, and you're spreading your weight evenly. So when you're feeling grounded, you can stop. Knees are soft, and then just do some gentle pelvic tilts. Try not to squeeze your bum as you tuck the pelvis under. Oh, I've got a fever bad today, so I apologise if I sound snuffly. And then make the movements smaller and smaller till you've found your middle ground, where your waters are calm and your bones relaxed. You're lifting equally through your ribs, we're not flaring at the front. Shoulders are down and back, are extending tall through the crown of your head. You're going to inhale through your nose if you can, and then exhale through pursed lips. So when we're breathing in, we're keeping the chest still, trying to get the breath into the bottom and the sides of the lungs and the back. And then when we're exhaling, we're going to start thinking about taking that pelvic floor up slightly. So just breathe at your own pace. And if you can't get the breathing, just breathe. It really doesn't matter. As long as you're moving that pelvic floor as much as you can throughout the session. And you have some times, once a day, twice a day hopefully, where you can just sit and think about your pelvic floor. Try and get it as strong as you can before you give birth. Okay, so we're gonna start off. Inhaling, turning the head to look over the shoulder. Exhale back to center. Over to the other side, back to center. We're not tilting through the head, just gently turning the neck and taking that pelvic floor up as we turn the head. We're going to add on this time, so you're going to inhale and turn your head. Exhale and shrug the opposite shoulder. Inhale, reach it down away from the ear. Exhale, turn your head back and other side. Inhale to shrug. Exhale to shrug and then inhale to lower. Exhale to return your head. Exhale, shrug the opposite shoulder. Inhale, reach away. Exhale, return. We're going to do one more on each side. Beautiful. Just going to do five shoulder rolls. So inhale as we take them forward and up. Exhale, back and down. Keeping our knees soft, and we're not moving through the pelvis or the ribs. So open up the shoulder blades and then squeeze them shut. last one. And then we're going to reverse it. So you squeeze and lift, open and lower. I'm going to take them back to centre. We're going to take the arms up so they're parallel to the floor. Rotate so the palms up to ceiling. We're going to inhale as we turn palms down, exhale as we open the back up. Inhale down, exhale back up. Keeping the weight even through your feet. Knees are soft. So if you want to take them a bit further, we can inhale and turn them past facing down, so we're trying to face back up, and then unwind on the exhale. So inhale, we turn palms face down, and then we keep rolling through the shoulders. Three more. Keep the arms as parallel to the floor as we can. And now we're going to circle from the elbow like we've been doing. So exhale as you take back of the hands to the armpits and out. Inhale, palms to the shoulders and through. Two more. Last one. And bring our arms across into a genie pose. So shoulders are down and back and arms are parallel to the floor. You're going to inhale and turn your body slightly to the corner of the room, exhale back to centre. Back to the same one and centre. If you want to add on, you're going to tap the foot out to the side, draw it in. Four more. So we're not over twisting, just a gentle turn to the corner of the room. Got nice count already, so we'll just do one more. Then, staying in this position, we're going to inhale, extend the arms and the leg, roll through the foot, down to the heel, bending the front knee, exhale back. Inhale, extend and roll, so stretching through the calf, exhale back. Making sure your foot is facing forwards as we roll down. Two more. Last one. Over to the other side. So we're going to inhale as we turn, exhale centre. Not taking it to a 90 degree, just taking it 45 degrees to the corner of the room. Add on the leg if you wish. Keeping your foot on the floor. But if you want more of a challenge, you can just float it off as you bring it in. Last one. And then we're going to roll through as we extend. Exhale back. Inhale, extend the arms, roll back through the foot. Exhale back. Two more. Last one. And shake the arms out. So we'll give the arms a break for a minute while we just do some pliés. So feet are just slightly wider than the hips, toes facing into the opposite corners. You're going to inhale as you slide down, knees come out, exhale as we come back up again. Inhale as we slide down, exhale up. If you can just go a tiny bit down, that is absolutely fine. Just a little bend in the knees, just to activate the quads. So we're keeping the knees pushed out. Exhaling, pelvic floor comes up, we come up. Push the ground away as you come back up. We're going to do four more. So you come down as low as you want. Last one. Now, arms out to the sides. We are going to roll the hands over and under into a side bend and back out. Inhale as we take it over, exhale back. palm on the bottom hand faces up, and the palm on the top hand faces down. Just gentle side movements. Slow it down if you're feeling a bit dizzy. And you take it over as far as you like to enjoy the stretch. One more each side. And then relax. So we're going to pivot round and drop a knee. So we're coming into our kneeling hip flexor. So our feet are on separate tracks. Knee is over under your hip. Squeeze your bum and then push forward so you feel a stretch in that hip. If you want to increase the stretch, you hold onto the hand of the leg that's back and just reach it up above your head and try and just squeeze your shoulder blades and arch back. Opening up through the front rather than crunching the back. Swapping your legs over. So knee is underneath your hip. Squeeze your bum, push it forwards until you feel a stretch in that hip flexor. Holding your wrist of the arm that's down with the leg. We're going to inhale as we reach up, so we're stretching away from us. And then exhale, come down. And come onto all fours. So we're going to do the cat stretch. So hands are underneath your shoulders, knees are underneath your hips. You are going to need some room either side of you and forward and backwards. Okay. So elbows are out to the sides, knees are underneath the hips. Don't have it so you're too crunched up or you're too far away because you'll not get the best out of the stretch. So extending through the crown of your head and your coccyx, you engage in that core. You're going to inhale into your side ribs and then we're going to exhale as we tuck the pelvis under and start rounding up, dropping the head down last. Hold the inhale and then exhale and wind back to centre. And again. So you only move how your body allows. If there isn't much room to tilt the hips, you can just do some abdominal hollowing. So we're just letting the belly hang out and then drawing it back in. Letting it go and then drawing it in. So just do what feels right for your body at this time. Okay, coming back into all fours. You're going to inhale as you extend the arm up, exhale as we flex through the wrist, swinging it behind us, and up. So my wrist is straight, and my arm's extended, and then I flex it as I come down, and try and push my tricep up to the ceiling. There's no movement through my hips, and my ears away from my shoulder. Two more. Swapping sides. So really reach your hand away from you, but leave your shoulder down away from your ears. And try and swing your arm up as far as you can without twisting through the body. All the time extending through the head. Two more. Lower it down. Okay, I'm just going to move forward because we need room behind us and I have a dog. So, back into your all fours. You're going to extend a leg out. We're going to inhale as we bring it out to the side as far as we can. Exhale as we take it across the body. Inhale as we bring it out. Exhale as we take it across. If you want more of a challenge, you can leave it in the air. But I really don't want you to be moving through the sides. So both sides stay as long as each other. There's no twisting and the hips are facing the floor. One more. Back to center. We're going to kick the bum toes pointed. Back down. Inhale, kick. Exhale, down. Last one with a pointed foot. Now we're going to draw the toes towards us. Kick the bum again, but this time the foot is flat to the ceiling and down. Point as you extend it out or tap it to the floor. This time we're going to do a double bounce. So we're going to point, flex, down. Two more. And then swap sides. Reposition yourself if you need to. Give your wrists a bit of a roll. Elbows out to the sides. Extend the leg out, across. Out as far as our legs allow. We're not moving through the sides. Five more. So we're working our bum. Stretching the IT band as we bring the legs over. Last one. Take it back to center. Tap the bum, heel to the bum. Exhale, extend. Toes pointed. Flex the foot as it comes up. Point it as it goes down. Control the rebound. So when we do the work, when we control and not let gravity take hold. This time we're going to point, flex, down pointed. Point, flex, down pointed. And then sit your bum back. So widen your knees. Sit your bum back and extend your arms. Taking your armpits to the floor. And then walk your hands in. Coming up to seated. So you're going to need the ball now. If you can't sit with a flat back and you are sat with your legs extended, sit yourself on a cushion, a book, a block, anything you've got. Wiggle your bum forward so that you've got a nice flat back. So legs are extended out. We are sat in the middle of our mat and legs are just either side of the mat. Toes are curled towards us, sitting nice and tall. Palms are together on the ball. You're going to inhale and then we're going to exhale, drop that chin to chest. Start to roll back through the spine as we bring the arms forward. Come forward as much as our body allows. Hold for your inhale and then exhale and wind from the base of the spine back up to the top. And again, so exhale, chin to chest, chest to ribs, take your belly back, run through the back and roll as far forward as we can. Your shoulders are pretty much over your hips and then exhaling, unwind bottom to top. So you're going to do four more. If you haven't got a ball, just pop your hands on the floor but try not to put any weight through them. And it's the same principle, you just slide your hands out. Try not to put much weight through them, just enjoying the stretch through the back. Hold for the inhale, hold for the inhale and then exhale and unwind. So inhale in, exhale chin to chest to rib, belly button goes back. We're trying to round over our bump as we're reaching forwards. Shoulders staying in line with the hips as much as possible. Exhale and unwind. So we're going to do two more. If you have got the ball, try not to put any weight through the ball. It's just there to guide you out and increase the stretch. Always moving on exhales,
pelvic floor up as we exhale down. And then pelvic floor up as we exhale up. Beautiful spine stretch. Okay, so we don't need the ball anymore. You're going to come onto your side. We're going to lay actually on the elbow if possible. So the elbow is underneath the shoulder, forearm down, hand flat on the floor. Our knee is in line with our elbow, and we're pushing our hips forward, not sinking into the side. You're going to inhale as you tap, try and get that, sorry, tap, you can't reach the floor, into a spine stretch. So reach the leg away from you, reach the top arm, keeping the shoulder down, exhale as we unwind. So we're going to do six of these. Inhaling as we're going over, pushing the floor away through the elbow, through the shoulder. Three more. So we're always reaching with the opposite foot, pushing the ground away through the forearm, through the elbow. Shoulders down away from ears. I've lost count, so I'll just do one more because it's really nice. Lovely. Then if we can, we're going to pop our hand on our hip and we're going to inhale as we lift the leg up, exhale, lower it down. So extend and lift. This is a real leg bum burner. So the leg isn't coming up very far. Two more, last one, lay yourself down, pad yourself out with pillows if you need to. We're just going to bring the bottom leg forward, rest that front foot over, and then we're going to inhale, lift the bottom leg, exhale lower. Hand can be on the floor for support or on the hip. Try not to put much weight through this leg. Two more. Hold it up. And we're just going to do little circles. And then the other way. And then release. And that is a real inner thigh burner. Bringing yourself back up. You're going to spin yourself around and do the other side. So, elbow is under the shoulder, palm is flat on the floor so we can put weight all the way through the arm. We're going to line the knee up with the shoulder and then push the hips forward, extending through that top leg. Inhale, reaching the arm over, looking at the mat, exhale lower. So my bottom leg is bent behind, my knees are in line with each other. I'm not sinking into the shoulder. The more you push the floor away and extend at the same time, the deeper the stretch. Last one. Hand on your hip. We're going to inhale, lift the leg, exhale, lower. Squeeze the bum and really engage your thigh as you lengthen the leg away. Pelvic floor comes up as leg lowers. Last one. Laying yourself down, pad yourself out with pillows if you need to. Straighten out the bottom leg, bring the top foot onto the floor. Draw the toes in towards you and then we're going to inhale and extend and lift the bottom leg, exhale lower. Our arm and foot are just here for support. The least amount of pressure you put through your arm and leg, the more you're going to work that inner thigh of the bottom leg. So hold it up, tiny circles.
Stop at the top, rewind. And then lower your leg down. Bring yourself back up to seated. And we're going to do our one-legged saw. So bring one foot into the groin, the other leg out. Toes drawn towards you, sitting nice and tall. We're going to have our hands in prayer position today. Thumbs in between the chest, shoulders down and back. Our head stays over our hands. So you're going to inhale as we turn towards the foot. Exhale, bring it back. Inhale as we turn. Exhale back. So I'm not expecting you to reach your foot. We're not even, like my hands aren't even anywhere near that leg. Two more. Last one. Swap your legs over. Making sure you're sitting nice and tall on your sitting bones. Curl the toes in. Hands in a prayer position again. Inhale as we turn towards the leg. Exhale, center. Don't force this movement. Pelvic floor comes up as we go back. All the time we are tall and extending through the crown of our head. Last one. Well done. Completely forgot, we do need a band. So, hit pause, go grab your band. If you haven't got a band, grab a scarf or a dressing gown. Belt. And I'll see you back. Have a drink if you want one. Okay, so, you're going to be kneeling. So legs are just wider than the hips, but toes are together at the back. So I am in this position. When we're up, we want to tilt our pelvis under and squeeze our bum to support our back. Our shoulders are in line with our hips. Okay, sit your bum down onto your feet. Trying to keep your back as straight as possible. We're going to lift up through the bum so we're back to that kneeling position. And as we do that, arms are going to come up and then go behind us with the band. So it's what we've been doing the last few weeks. Make sure your band is not too tight that you're having to stagger through your shoulders, and it's not too loose that you're not really achieving anything. So once you've found your resistance, you're going to inhale, push up as the arms come up and over, and then we're going to exhale to bring the arms back and down. Inhale up and over, exhale back and down. If you can't feel the movement with the breath, just breathe in whatever way feels natural for you. Because there is a bit of breath holding if we haven't got a long enough breath. And I do not want you to hold your breath. So we're working through the thighs, stretching out the chest, and working the shoulders. Don't forget to take your pelvic floor up as we go back down. Gonna do two more. Okay, this time we're gonna go up and leave it behind us. We're gonna rotate through the hands so that the band's wrapped around the front of the hands and your palms are facing behind you. We're gonna inhale as we lift the arms up. Exhale, lower them down. Really squeeze through the shoulder blades. Still nice and tall. Pelvis is still tucked under. We're going to do four more. Keep a nice long neck. So you're reaching your arms up and away from you. Been doing these the last couple of weeks. I've done more than four more. So unwind your band and bring it back over. Sit your bum down, bring your knees in, and we're just going to stretch out our arms. So
So take the arm over and between your shoulder blades. And then bring it across the chest. When we take it across the chest, we don't want the shoulder to be up by the ears. So really extend it down and reach through the hand. Over to the other side. Try not to flare through the ribs as you've got the arm up and over. And then take it across the body. Shoulder down. And then relax your arms. So, coming onto a hip. Bring one foot forward so that the leg is in line with the mat. Hold the foot of the back leg. And then if we can, we're going to lift the knee up, take it as far back as we can, roll through the shoulders to open up the chest, push the hips forward, so you're feeling a stretch across the front of the hips, across the shoulders, and in your quad. If you want, we can take the foot up to the ceiling to get a different part of our quad. And then lower it down, take it over to the other side. So only move in your own range of movement, what feels good for your hips. You don't want to overstretch your hips, but you do need to give them just a bit of a stretch because they've got such a workload going off at the minute. So it's finding that really fine balance, so only you can tell what feels good for your body and what you really shouldn't be doing. And relax. Swinging that leg around, we're going to come sole to sole. Lifting your bum up, drawing your feet in as close to your body as you can. Sitting nice and tall, just swing through the legs. Crunch your bum. And then bring yourself back. So we are going to inhale and take your pelvic floor up. Hold it for 5 seconds and then exhale and let it go again. So breathing at your own rate, taking the pelvic floor up on the inhales, and then if it's still there, let it go on the exhale. Keep your bum relaxed, your jaw soft, and don't push your tongue into the roof of the mouth. Legs are getting uncomfy, just cross them and say, are we comfy? Otherwise, we are going to imagine we've got four corners in our pelvis and we are going to pick our pelvic floor up and drop it. Quick fire pulses in each corner. Just keep going corner to corner till you've gone around your square or rectangle, however many times you want to go around it. Okay, whatever we're doing, reverse it. So this is really important to keep your tongue still, relax your bum, keep your eyes still, jaw relaxed. So it's just your pelvic floor that's working. Now see if you can draw your dots up, drawing an imaginary line from corner to corner. And then reverse it. And then relax your pelvic floor. Just bring your legs forward a little bit if we are still sole to sole. And then round your knee back out. Just try and roll over, round over, sorry, not roll over. Chin to chest. Just stretching out your spine. Letting your head hang. Trying to get rid of all the tension in your body. And then roll yourself up. Coming onto our elbows.
Make sure you're still on the flat of your pelvis, you're not overarching or tucking your pelvis under. You're going to cross one foot over the other, and then if we can, just let your knees fall to the side, foot lands on the floor. Feel a bit of a stretch in the base of your back and your bum. And then bring your bum back, swapping your legs over. Let it fall to the opposite side. Foot rests on the floor if you can. And if you want, you can turn your head in the opposite direction. And then come back. Bringing yourself over onto your knees. We're just going to do a kneeling hip flex stretch again. So your foot is flat on the floor. Knees underneath your hip, squeeze your bum and push your hip forward. Grabbing your hand of the leg that's back, you're going to inhale as we reach the arms up into an arch, reaching rather than crunching. And then lower it down and push your bum back, swapping sides. Squeeze your bum of that bottom leg, push it forward, grabbing your hand. So lengthen through your arms, drawing an arch rather than crunching through your spine. Breathing at your own pace and then push yourself out of it. Bringing yourself up to standing. Just going to circle the hips round. And then take it back the other way. Making sure you tuck in and tilt in the pelvis. Not just rocking side to side, unless that's what you fancy doing at this time. And then just shake it all out. Okay, so realigning. Feet are hip width apart, toes are facing forwards. Just gently rock forwards and backwards. Lifting your heels and the balls of your feet off slightly. Spreading your weight through your four corners and your toes. So you can feel grounded. Your feet. Knees are soft, and then we're just going to do some small pelvic tilts again. And then make the movements smaller and smaller till you've found your middle ground where your waters are calm. Bum's relaxed. Equally lifting through the ribs, shoulders are down and back, and extending tall through the crown of your head. Inhale as you take your arms up one last time, and then exhale, pelvic floor comes up as we lower the arms. And well done. That was your session. Hope you enjoyed it. You're doing well in your pregnancy, and see you next week. Bye.